It feels magical. It feels meditative. It feels really quiet. It's almost like time slows down. There's just something. There's something about it. My passion for this research came about because I have always loved mermaids. It's always been something I've really identified with. I've always kind of paid attention, looked out for mermaid texts. But for some reason, I never really considered it as an object of scholarly analysis. And now, mermaids is my life's work. Even though my project is about Black mermaids more broadly, one of the things I'm really zeroing in on is this idea of the Middle Passage as the birth of mermaid species. And I call this idea the crossing merfolk. I'm really excited about this unit because we're talking about crossing merfolk. And this is the thrust of my book project. So we have a lot of people feel within Afrofuturism studies and within Black popular culture studies that there's too much trauma, that there's too much pain. So that's like one of the main things that I'm interested in is how Black artists can take this idea that's so full of trauma and pain and violence and brutality as the experience of the Middle Passage, and they can conceptualize it in a way where there's also this connection to rebirth into something magical and something beautiful. There have been a lot of scholars that have been writing in mermaid studies. However, they've mostly been ignoring Black mermaid lore, right? And so it's important because one of the things I'm thinking about in this project is that Black people also need access to whimsy. We also need access to fantasy. We also need access to magic. And I just don't think that there's any more awe-inspiring image or idea than that of the mermaid. The early months of the pandemic, I was watching professional mermaid videos and it was like stress relief. And that's what inspired me. And I've never had time before, I'm gonna do this. So I finally took lessons. So it's like, it actually motivated me. I'm still a baby mermaid because I'm still early in this journey. I just learned to swim a few years ago, partly because I have a young child and because I wanna be a mermaid. I loved Disney growing up. I loved princesses. I loved fairy tales because for me as a little girl, that was kind of all you had in terms of female-centered, woman-centered stories. And even though there's more options now for young girls to identify with, I still think that it's important that all girls get to see someone who looks like them. The fact that these little girls are seeing it at this age, yeah. And like, how would that expand their capacity for what is possible for them? I'm here for the little Black girls. That's who I'm excited for. There's a long way to go. And I mean, I always say that representation isn't everything, but representation does matter because it helps to determine the limits of your possibilities. In the English department here, we have a lot of freedom to kind of focus your courses on what you want to. It's not often that you can find that you get to do that and also get the resources to do the kind of research that you want to do. It's the perfect place to do science fiction and fantasy work. So I focus my history of fantasy and horror course on mermaids. So there's a kind of fun connection of this to The Little Mermaid. I've known that Halle Bailey was cast to be The Little Mermaid for years now, because I'm a mermaid freak. But when the trailer came out recently, there was a lot of controversy around her casting. And so there was this woman on Twitter that I follow, and she said, all the Africans y'all threw in the sea, and now y'all surprised a mermaid is Black, right? And so not only did this tweet get viral, Twitter took it down because they said it was offensive, right? And it was like, why is it offensive to state a fact? I think that this crossing merfolk idea, this intersection of mermaids in the Middle Passage, provides a way to think about how you can bear witness to the history, but how you can do it in a way that allows you to experience also some healing as well.
There is a whole history of Black people being expert swimmers and being experts within all of these aquatic sports, but getting alienated from that through racial chattel slavery, through segregation.
One of the reasons for keeping people from swimming was because it was an escape route. Because if you're running away, you want to pass through water as often as possible so that the hounds can lose your scent. So if people didn't learn to swim, that made it harder for them to escape. And that's a lot of that within Black history of having things, of being forcibly disconnected from those things and then trying to put the connection back together yourself.
I think that the mermaid is one of the ways through which to explore and to actually heal that relationship to water.
Y'all remember when the regime changed that?
I can't stop myself. My unit around the crossing merfolk, which was definitely one of the most powerful teaching experiences I've ever had, because my students are all coming from different backgrounds, different ethnicities, and so often what's happening in these texts is artists and authors who are using the mermaid to imagine a way to connect to an ancestral past that was stolen from them, using it as a way to work through a trauma and a violence that they've inherited intergenerationally. And that's something that a lot of my students could identify with.
Thank you, Professor.
You're welcome. Thank you.
I just wanted to say, thank you for today's class. It's really, really informative. And just, like, as an Indigenous American who's, like, displaced and trying to reconnect to this stuff, it's really, really, like, emotional. Aww. I had a really good class today, so thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate that. Being able to have that level of vulnerability in a classroom while also doing the kind of rigorous analysis of text that's always one of my objectives. To see the vulnerability helps students get to the analysis, and the analysis helped them to get to some kind of deeper meaning for themselves personally. It's just, that's it. Like, that's the chef's kiss of teaching. As a faculty member, there just isn't a better possible place for me because of the kind of work and the project that I'm doing fits right in. I really think that UC Riverside is the best possible place for me. It's one of the most powerful experiences I've ever had, and this Mermaids project is one of the things that got me there.